Have you ever experienced a vague feeling of want? Of wanting to be in that world, feel what that cast feels, and dream of what that world would be like and how it would treat you? Well, if I'm the only one, then I certainly won't take any shame in it, let alone hate myself for it. You see, Violet Evergarden is like a newfound world in which you get to be there and follow the main cast from every high to every low, and where I can assure you that from the get-go you will not only be invested, but at the same time find yourself crying your heart out for reasons you'd never expect. It's not to say that this show might have wanted to add a beware of emotions taking yaoi sign. However, Violet Evergarden still gave me the bright moments as well as showed me the different viewpoints one could have in life and why you should never think that there's no good to come. That's why today I'll be dusting off this 1-year-old anime, showing it some love and showcasing its reasons for being voted so highly in the anime community. Without further ado, here goes. Violet Evergarden is an anime made up of 13 stunningly beautiful episodes that captivates the viewer by the landscape and environment of Telesis. We also discover new places unknown to our protagonist as we follow her on her journey. It's a thrilling ride, and even though we learn a bit more about Violet, we also get to hear the story of those requesting the letters, and that's so great. And once for all, they actually don't feel like side characters, and more so like real characters with their own personal feelings and their own story. I can't begin to count how many times my eyes have either been on the verge of shedding tears, or just full out waterfall mode. Yes, that's my way of saying I cried a lot. One could compare it to the ending scene in the Anohana show, for those of you who might know that, or those of you who are long anime fans. I mean, come on, you got to have cried just a little bit when that ending song hit, like, wow. Anyway, Wild Evergarden started airing on January 11, 2018 and ended with the 13 episodes on 5th of April the same year, and it's gotten a score of 8.61 on my anime list. Well, who am I kidding anyways? No one cares about the scores. Kyoto Animations as the studio behind the show has made great strides in the right direction when making this both a hard hitter for the emotionally invested and a fantastic anime for those just in need of some afternoon Netflix and chill. Without the chill part. Or the Netflix part. Or maybe neither. Just don't read into it too much, okay? Regardless, the anime was published as a Netflix original and became nominated for one of the best shows of the year on Crunchyroll Awards 2018. As many of you might know, Kyoto Animation is the studio behind many great shows like the Free series, K-On!, Nijijō, as well as the films The Disappearance of Haruhi Suzumiya, A Silent Voice, otherwise named as Kono Katachi, which I so brilliantly remembered, and Liz and the Bluebird, to name a few. Last but not least, you also have the more known series for breaking your heart and making you cry like ever before, Clannad and Clannad After Story specifically. I wish you all good luck if you ever decide to sit through all of Clannad's story, or at least the Clannad After Story, because goddamn, I've heard it's a field trip. Well, I'll wait. I'll wait right here. Tell me when you're finished. When it comes down to the story of Violet Evergarden, we start off in the stunningly beautiful continent of Telesis, where after 4 years of war, peace has finally been achieved. This is where we meet Violet Evergarden, a young girl of 14 years of age, who has been scarred by war in more ways than one could imagine. Her arms now prosthetic arms of adamant silver. However, she seems oblivious to her current state, as she only sees one objective in mind, and that is to getting back to her major, so that she can continue to serve whatever order may be given to her. She even tries with all her power to scribble down some lines on paper to send to the major without any luck due to her new prosthetic arms. These arms become a staple to what hurdles she has been through and what she's got left to come throughout the story. When she gets escorted to the city by a new caretaker, Lieutenant Hodgins, otherwise known as President throughout the story, Violet cannot begin to comprehend what the words "I love you" means. We get a flashback to her major uttering those last few words as his life slowly slips away from him in the depths of the cave they were in. Despite her seeing this, the fact that her major died in front of her is something she never understood. This prompts her to asking questions about the Major anytime she can, saying things like, "Has the Major asked for me? Have I received any new orders from the Major? And have you heard anything from the Major?" While she asked these questions, I could not help but sympathize with the President, as the hurt in his eyes could easily be seen, and his voice heard cracking with the scarce words, "No. I'll make sure to let you know when he does." While he's holding back the bitter truth as to protect her from being crushed to pieces. As she starts to work in the Ultimemory Doll office, we get to see Violet go from executing every task as if it was an order, even to the point of not taking any breaks or even stopping to eat. This affects the rest of the crew, as they begin to wonder how she seems so lifeless and why her personality seems devoid of any feelings. Iris and Erica, some of her fellow Ultimemory Doll employees, soon find out that she's been in war her whole life, and that her understanding of feelings and their meaning is vague. This becomes a problem throughout the story, where contradictions add yet another element of depth to the difficult mountain of a challenge that Violet so impressively tries to take on. Her skill gets tested in every way when she decides to ask the President to work with writing letters for her clients. One sent letter from a client to his or her chosen recipient could hold so much power, especially since this was the end of the war and most people didn't even know how to write or read. Despite the repetitiveness of Violet failing at every moment when expressing her feelings on the behalf of her clients, she still manages to slowly but surely grasp at the idea of contradictions and feelings bit by bit. This is the main plot point of the story, to see her grow as a human being and get better at what she so desperately wants to understand. It didn't occur to me until I was at least halfway into episode 4 how much I was rooting for this character to succeed. Seeing her rough start ending with a lot of complaints from customers to her first ever sentence of the feeling, "I'm so happy you are alive," that was sent to her friend's brother, made me so happy. I could see the joy in her friend's face as well as her surprise that Violet had finally been able to express someone's feeling on a paper. This was despite it being merely one sentence, it still held such power that it could unite the brother with the sister. The anime storyline holds a lot of power to it, so I don't want to spoil the rest and therefore I will move on to the visuals. Please go watch this show. One word, stunning. I don't know exactly where to start. This show's visuals made me go wild with excitement from the get-go. I've always been a fan of great colors, fantastic detailed scenes, and it just took my breath away. They managed to capture every moment from the hardships of battle with great colors and details of blood, to the happy moments where more vibrant, brighter colors could be seen. I know a lot of people don't take into account how much the visuals matter to them, however, at least personally, it makes or breaks whether a show becomes a good show, or if it becomes a fantastic show I just want to get back to it every single second. It's the kind of show you can literally take every frame and drop it onto your desktop as a wallpaper, or poster, for those old people out there. Losers. Wait. Damn it. I have one too, actually. But it's not of anime! Got a body pillow too, actually. To summarize the show, it is a great piece of art in my eyes. It's not to say that it doesn't have flaws to it. But then again, I wanted to showcase the good sides of the anime, to try and make the people who second question themselves whether they were going to actually watch the show or not, actually do it. Because I know I did. But when I got into it, it became more of an immersive story that I enjoyed all the more the further I ventured into it. I would definitely recommend this show to anyone, even the people who are new to anime, as the visuals and the fact that I believe everyone can find someone or some element of this story that they can relate to. I hope you guys enjoy this review, and until next time, keep on watching anime, you filthy weeps. One more thing. There's this one phrase that always comes back to me. A phrase from the show that hit me so hard Not the first time I heard it, but the second one. It held such power that I didn't know how to express myself. The feelings, they just bubbled up inside me. I'm surprised by the impact, and I hope those words will impact you too. Here they are.